Hi, my name is Alexander Ward, and I'm making a coloring book. A coloring book inspired by my time living in the Amazon jungle. And this is a video series to show the entire process of creating this coloring book. And so in this episode, I'm going to be showing the entire creation of one of the very first pages to go into the book. Alright, so taken from the series of thumbnail sketches I made previously, this is one of the pages that was named Pawprints, and based on the idea of following these pawprints deep into the jungle, as in this story, through the book, we seem to be following a jaguar on its journey through the jungle. So, this is the very rough thumbnail sketch, and what I'm going to do is lower the opacity and then create a new layer over the top and make a more refined sketch of this page. And that'll be the first part of the process, and then the next one will be I got to then make another layer of the top of that to create the clean line. So let's get started on the sketch section. Alright, so this is me starting the more refined sketch. I've chosen to use the program Coral Painter. Not sure if I'll keep using this program to do all my pages. It's just what I'm trying out for now. I may find a better alternative. So my method for drawing trees hasn't really changed in the past like 5 or so years. I used to study trees quite a bit when I had a particular project I needed to design tree houses for. And I studied a lot of the trees in Angkor Wat, like those amazing trees that grow from the temples. And that's always influenced my style of drawing trees, where you can see very obvious little, it's almost like vines that all wrap around and spiral upwards. So it's quite a bit of an artistic license, my trees. They look quite alien, but I don't know, I quite like it. This whole page in itself was very reminiscent of my very earliest days in the jungle. And I guess this is also reflected because this is also one of the very first pages in the book, where it feels very intimidating. I was very much frightened of my own shadow. And I, during those early days, I stayed in a treehouse that was about a 20-30 minute walk from anyone else around me, around like the communal areas. So each day I would have to walk down, well, through this jungle path, all alone in deep jungle, and constantly keeping an eye out for any sight of danger in the jungle flora, because it's very dense jungle around me, and I was always on the lookout for eyes watching me. And I always had in the back of my mind this idea that there would be a jaguar just sitting in front of me down the path, and I think this is really what the the page kind of conjures up in my memory of living in the jungle. And yeah, just trying to get that sense of, although there was a quite a clear, defined path through the jungle that had been used for quite a while, that, yeah, on either side it was very dense and very dangerous feeling.
Okay, so I've done the sketch now for this page, the following the paw prints through the jungle environment. And yes, this is how messy my sketches look. I use different colors because I end up putting down so many lines that I just end up confusing myself. So I need to do different colors for different objects in the page. So tomorrow morning, first thing, I'm gonna go ahead and just make a new layer on top of this one, and then turn this other layer down, and I will proceed to trace over it. Yeah, just the long process of tracing over, obviously I'll do it proper. But, and then, you know, I'll add in more details. I will most likely zoom in quite close to this. Okay. So I know that if I draw at 48%, I will be drawn at the size of... Oh no, what have I done? That's fine. That person will be looking at the page, so I know. And I want to do this because, you know, if I zoom in at 100% and I'm doing all these tiny little details, I'm drawn at double the size here. So I'm drawn double the amounts of detail, and it's probably going to be the details, or like the distance between the lines, is going to be too thin for people to color in. And I've got a few coloring books myself, because I, you know, scouted out the competition and whatnot. And I found that when some of the lines are just too close together, it just ends up becoming a little bit frustrating because it's too detailed, and it ends up becoming not as relaxing as it ought to be. There needs to be, in each image, varying levels of different spaces between the lines, so that when a person comes and looks at the entire page, and they see the whole image and they go, God, that's a lot to color in. Okay, so maybe if I just start with the easiest bits, which is gonna be this big block of color here. And I'll work my way up to coloring in the little fine bits. I'm actually going to be deleting this layer. I'm having a little practice with the line tool I'm using. I still haven't quite decided on what my method of line art style is going to be. So there's many different lines. You need to vary thin and thick lines. So, let's pick this as an example. I can actually make that a bit thinner. Okay, so everything inside an item has a line of a particular thickness, and when you go to the outside, the line is like a little bit thicker. Pretty basic technique, pretty basic. However, many people overlook it. And you know, when you get like even closer to the camera, or I mean, there's no camera, but closer to the viewer, the lines get thicker still. And this just helps it that when you have, as I often do with my artwork, just like so much going on in the image, it helps differentiate from the different items. Like when there's an item crossing over another, let's just say that it's got like that has that there and that has that there. It just just helps you, like it just pops it over the other item a bit. Okay. Well, with that, I will start on the cleanup line of this tomorrow. See you in the morning. Peace.
Alright, so I've just finished the line art, the clean line art for this page, and I did a screen recording. So this is it played back in time lapse, and just gonna talk a little bit about it, the process that went behind it. This being one of the very first pages, not sure I quite nailed down the final line art style. I believe I was a little bit heavy-handed with some of the line work. I think the line quality is a little bit thick. I think I could be a bit lighter with it, and so I'll try to refine that a little bit more in the next page. It was It was very relaxing to draw this. Especially once you get past the refined sketch stage, which is the most thought-intensive process, where you're really trying to build the sketch and define all the little elements within it. But when you get to this stage currently, more or less, you just tend to be tracing over the lines, and it's a very therapeutic act. But a bit disappointed that I won't be able to colour this, so I'm going to be drawing all 50 of these page illustrations, and I'm not sure I'm ever going to have the time to actually colour them. It's it feels like I'll always take it to a half-finished state and then not be able to finish it by colouring it. So I'm hoping a good 6 or so months down the line, when I finished every page, I'll finally get the copy of the book in my hands, and I'll just spend about a couple weeks colouring every single page. But doing this very early page, it's slowly starting to dawn on me that this whole book is going to take a lot longer than I thought it would, which is usually the case. Things always take 3 times longer than you ever expect them to, especially when it comes to artwork, and I don't think this is going to be an exception. I thought it was going to take 3-4 months. It's probably going to take 6, 7, 8, 9, I don't know. It's going to take a long time. So I better start enjoying colouring while drawing each page. Also, I feel that as I'm still trying to find the art style, as I go through the process of making this coloring book, I'm going to get a lot quicker doing these pages, and as I get used to the style and find what it is, I would just be able to knock them out, I hope, super quick, because this one felt like it took far too long. All these little grass roots and little details. I'm an excellent noodler, and a noodler is someone who spends far too much time on all the little details. But I have a bit of an OCD tendency in me, so actually working on this coloring book is great therapy for that. It just allows me to pour all that OCD energy into the drawings that I do, and I guess kind of I've discovered that about myself when I with my artwork, that it's all very intricate and detailed and perfectionist, but that's a way for me to get out that OCD nature in me. With this bit, I'm just sketching it a different color, because I felt like I didn't quite refine this area in that initial sketch, so it was a little unclear for me, and I didn't have the confidence to just go ahead and create final clean line work for this area, so I needed to just do a bit more on sketch. Yeah, in the jungle there was a lot of plants that were just towering above me. I just remember at times just being completely taken aback and in awe at just the size of the jungle flora. It's the same type of sensations I felt when I went to New York, and as someone coming from Great Britain, we really don't have very huge tall buildings as compared to somewhere like New York, and it really, you just end up staring upwards all the time. And I had that same feeling seeing all the jungle plant life as someone who comes from Great Britain, where our plant life isn't quite as tall as it is in the jungle. I wasn't too sure about this element, where if I was gonna fill in these heavy black elements or not. But I think I wanted to bring across that darkness within a jungle, so I kept it in. So here in the image, I'm just going over some of the drawn elements to make those lines thicker, to make them pop out against the elements behind them. And that's it for the page. Page 1 of 50 is down, I guess. I gotta move on to the other 49. I'm looking forward to how much my drawing improves. Actually, that's what I'm most excited about. If I'm at this level at page 1, by page 50, I'm thinking the pages are going to be quite a bit better. Probably so much so that I'm going to want to return back to the previous drawings and just want to redo them all, but if I do that, it'll just be a never-ending process, so I'll have to sort of hold myself back a bit with that. Okay, well, that is the page Pawprints. That's over and done with, and the next page, I'm not sure what page I'm going to be doing next, but I guess we'll see. So, until next time, peace.